Thanks, Andrew. Look what I have. An alligator.
They told me to bring the 13-foot python for you, but
I'm glad you didn't.
We went easy on with a little alligator.
So we have Charlie here from the Gladys Porter Zoo. He brought an American alligator. This is a baby alligator. Tell us about him.
It's young. It's about maybe about 2 years old, a little bit more than that. It came to us, I don't think we've even had it in a year, but it's a great educational tool that we have there as part of our animal ambassador program, because we have alligators right here in South Texas, and people, you know, sometimes they have a little misconception of them. They're always need to be respected and kept at a distance. One of the things that we constantly tell people is if you see an alligator, just leave it be. The worst thing you can do is feed it, because if you feed an alligator, it kind of sees you as a food source, and that's when you can get into some problems.
Mm-hmm. And these things get pretty big.
Yeah, they get big. So I don't know if it's a male or female yet. So if it's a female, it'll kind of grow to maybe around 8 or 9 feet. If it's a male, they can get very large, maybe up to somewhere around 14 feet, maybe even larger depending on the age. And they could live for 70 plus years. Yeah.
Okay. Wow. Any a name for this one, or we don't know yet?
His name is Gus. Yeah, he's very popular there at the zoo, and everybody loves him. Every time we take him anywhere, they just think he's the coolest thing in the world, because he is.
He's really calm.
He is really calm, and I told you, you're doing really good holding him, and there's just like a specific way to just make him comfortable. Alligators have, or crocodilians in general, they do like little bursts of energy, so sometimes he might like wiggle around, but for the most part.
It seems like he's just maybe shy. I don't know.
He's shy. Well, we had him out a little bit earlier in the lobby. Everybody was like oohing, ahhing over
he's
him.
Like, I'm so, over it. Yeah. I'm just going to chill here.
He's good. That's why the alligators are really great ambassadors, because they're very relaxed. And I found it the hard way right here on this news desk a few years back that crocodiles can rotate their head a lot more than an alligator.
I got
a little bite, but it was a baby, so it didn't really matter that much.
And you may have noticed a black tape around the mouth. I was asking Charlie about that. There's a reason for that.
Yeah, so it is a directive through Parks and Wildlife when we have, when we do present an American alligator to the public. It does have, no matter what size, it does have to be taped just as a precaution, because believe it or not, they do have little small teeth, but they are sharp. You know, if they got a hold of you, it would hurt at, you know, whatever size they are.
Okay, so you have an event going on. Tell us about that.
Yeah, so of course, if you want, you know, something for your kids to do, you can head out to the Gladys Porter Zoo. We have summer safari camps. We have 2-day classes. We have week-long camps. And tonight we have a sleepover with the kids, and it's designated just for that camp. But tomorrow, the 21st on Saturday, we are gonna have a public starlight. So you can join, anybody in the valley can, or anybody can join that starlight, and they do a night tour around the zoo. They have, you know, dinner, they get an animal presentation, and you can bring your sleeping bags, your tent, anything, and you can go and camp out there at the zoo.
Okay, awesome. Well, we appreciate it, Charlie. Thanks for stopping by and bringing your friend over here. And he's still very calm, not moving? Nope, okay. All right, stay with us, we'll be right back.